enjoyed that. As always, you're tuning in to Children's Ministry. Thank you for every week tuning in to us, listening to the Word of God that He has just for you. So get your Bibles, get your phones, your tablets, whatever you have that Bible on, and we're going to get into the Word on today. I'm so excited for the Word that God has to share with us on today. And last time we talked about Jesus, when we're in trouble, how He understands what we go through. And now we're going to talk about how when in times of trouble, how Jesus protects us. So let's begin and pray. Father, we come just to thank You for this day. We thank You for Your Word. We thank You for Jesus. We thank You for the Holy Spirit. God, we pray as we're reading and meditating upon Your Word on today, we thank You that Your Holy Spirit will lead, God, and direct us in all that we need to know. Father, He will reveal to us those things that which You have for us on this day, oh God. And we will be careful to give You all the honor, the praise, and the glory for everything that shall be said and done. In Jesus' name we pray. All right, faith kids, let's go first to our memory verse in Psalms. I know you know the book of Psalms. It's over in the Old Testament, right before after Job and before Proverbs. So our memory scripture is Psalms 103. And we're going to read stanza number 13. Stanza 13. So if you would turn there to Psalms 103, stanza 13. This is our memory scripture for this week. I know you're reading your scriptures throughout the week and letting the Holy Spirit reveal God's word to you and what He's saying to us through these scriptures. It's very important to meditate, God says, upon His word daily that we can have good success. So in the scripture, it reads, "The Lord is like a father to His children, tender and compassionate to those who fear Him." It says God is like our Father. He's tender. He's compassionate to us, to those who fear Him. And when we're talking about fearing the Lord, it is not as we're afraid of Him and scared of Him. No, we reverence Him. So it's not being afraid of God, but it's reverencing who God is in our lives. So that's your memory verse from this week. I want you to meditate upon that. Let the Holy Spirit speak to you on those scriptures and what God wants to you to know and revealing Himself to you through that verse on today. So now let's go over to our lesson on today in Matthew, first book in the New Testament, Matthew chapter 18. So as you turn there, we're talking about Jesus protects us. And when we're in trouble, when things got, Jesus is protecting us. And you want to always know He is your protector, faith kids. He watches over you. So we're going to just learn a little about that. And Jesus protects us as you're there in chapter 18, reading verse number 5 and 6. "And anyone who welcomes a little child like this on my behalf is welcoming me. But if you cause one of these little ones who trust in me to fall into sin, it will be better for you to have a large millstone tied around your neck and be drowned in the depths of the sea." Did you hear that? That's how much God loves you, protects you, watches over you. He says that anything that happens, if someone causes you to fall into doing things bad, into sin, He says they might have just tied like a stone around their neck and just go down to the bottom of the ocean. And we know that when you get that stone, it helps you to stay down in the water, right? To drown. So that's what He says. Anyone who causes you to go into sin, He says they might as well have just drowned in the sea. Because why? God loves you and He protects you. He watches over you. So let's drop down to verse number 10 in this same chapter. It says, "Beware that you don't look down on any of these little ones. For I tell you that in heaven, their angels are always in the presence of my heavenly Father." So Jesus is saying that He watches over us. God has His angels watching and protecting over us. So in Psalms 23, I know you've read Psalms 23, faith kids. It talks about that the Lord is my shepherd. So we talk about a shepherd because a shepherd watches over the sheep and watches over, you know, the flock. So that's what Jesus is to us. He is our shepherd. We are the flock. We are the sheep. He watches over us. And what does shepherds do, faith kids? They watch over the sheep to make sure what? Make sure that they're not hurt. Make sure that everything is, that they're fed, they have everything that they need. Nothing is there to harm you. I know you know the story of David. What was David doing? He was a shepherd who watched over the sheep, right? He protected them from everything. And what it even told us that what? He protected the sheep from a lion, from a bear. David went up against, can you imagine fighting a bear, fighting a lion? And it says, even in the scripture, it says that David literally took one of the lambs out the mouth of the lion. So the lion had that lamb, but David took it out his mouth. That means he is right up and close and personal with that lion, defeating it. That's how God feels about us. That's how Jesus is our shepherd. He is right there to protect us, to help us. No matter what situation and trouble we're in, he's there to protect us. He's watching over us. The scripture said he's allowing his angels. Did you read that in 10? He says, "For I tell you that in heaven, their angels are always in the presence of the Heavenly Father." He has his angels there saying, "Watch over my children. Make sure that they're protected. Make sure that they're good." So he has his angels, giving his angels charge over us. So as a shepherd who watches over us, that's what Jesus is to us. He watches over us to protect us. So let's read on in verse number 12. "If a man has 100 sheep and one of them wanders away, what will he do? Won't he leave the 99 others on the hills and go after to search for the one that is lost? And if he finds it, I tell you the truth, he will rejoice over it more than over the 99 that didn't wander away. And in the same way, it is not my Heavenly Father's will that even one of these little ones should perish." So we're talking about being God, Jesus being our shepherd. It says that if one gets lost, he will, even if he has 100 sheep, and he one goes away and goes astray, he says he leaves the 99. You would think, well, you know, it's just one, it's okay. That one is, you know, I have all of these. No, God says one of us is very important to him. He says he will leave the multitude just to go after to make sure that one comes safely back into the fold. That's how he feels about you, faith kids. He does not even want not even one of us to go astray. Because think about it, when that one sheep gets out amongst the multitudes, he's off by himself. What happens? That's like the enemy wants us to get off by ourselves and get us away from, you know, what we know. So he can, look, he's prey. That means he's out there by himself. There's no one watching over him. There's no one to protect him. He can fall in a hole and get hurt. Other wild animals can come, you know, and attack, and they have attacked the sheep and they have him, right? But God says, no, no, not even one. I'm going after that one to protect them. So he's concerned about even one of us going astray. So we're like the lost sheep. But God says, I sent Jesus here that he will bring even the one back to me. So he wants all of us to come back to him. That's why Jesus came on this earth, faith kids, that he brings us back to the Father. We were his lost sheep, but now when we confess Jesus as our Lord and Savior and we believe that he died on the cross for us and he rose from the dead, then he says, we're back in the fold. We're back in his presence. We're back a part of the kingdom of God. And it's very important. He says that, look at the scripture. It read that even one, he's concerned about even one. He does not even want one little one to get lost, to be gone. He doesn't want to lose anyone. Isn't that great news, faith kids, that God loves us so much that He's concerned that not even one should perish, that not even one should go astray. He's sending Jesus just after each and every one of us. So we're saying, God protects us. Jesus protects us. He watches over us, has His angels given charge over us, that He's keeping us safe. So that's how much He loves us, He cares for us, and He protects us, faith kids. So I want you to know, on today, the Word says that Jesus protects us, that He's watching after us, that we will not be led astray. He's watching over us, that nothing, the enemy cannot come trying to harm us. He's there to protect us. He's there to protect you, faith kids. So remember, read your memory scripture on this week, Psalms 103, stanza 13, and know that the Holy Spirit wants to speak to you through the scripture, that God wants to reveal Himself to you more personally through His words, that you will grow and be who He has called you to be, faith kids. Have a great and awesome week this week. I know you're back to school and you're having a great time. So we'll see you on next week, faith kids. Have a blessed week.